Class 5 IMO Level 2. Mathematics question number 16. If the area of 12 identical squares is 768 square centimeter, then find the perimeter of a square. In order to find the area of one square, we have to divide the total square centimeter by the number of squares, which is equal to 64 square centimeter. In order to find the side of one square, we have to put in the formula A square or A into A. So 8 8s are 64. Now we have to find the perimeter of a square. Perimeter of a square is equal to 4a, and one side is equal to 8 cm. We have to multiply 4 into 8, which is equal to 32 cm. Mathematics question number 17. How many angles inside the given figure are equal to 3 right angles? One right angle is equal to 90 degrees. So 90 plus 90 plus 90 is equal to 270 degrees. So we have to find out how many angles in the figure is 270 degrees. There are 6 270 degrees in this figure. Mathematics question number 18. The value of the given numerals. Here they have asked to find the value of the Roman numerals. The answer to the first part is 3869. And the answer to the second part is 2550. They have asked to subtract it. So if we subtract, we'll get 1319. That is the C option. Mathematics question number 19. Kunal cut a wire and bent it to form 6 similar rectangles. The breadth of each rectangle is 4 cm less than half of its length. If the breadth of the rectangle is 18 cm, what is the original length of the wire? Breadth of the rectangle is 18 cm. The breadth of each rectangle is 4 cm less than half of its length. Given, breadth is equal to length divided by 2 minus 4. If we bring it to the other side, we will get 18 plus 4 is equal to length by 2. From this, we can find the length, that is equal to 44 cm. Perimeter of one rectangle is equal to 2 into L plus B. So if we substitute the values, we'll get 124 cm. So perimeter of 6 rectangles is equal to 124 cm into 6, that is equal to 744 cm. Therefore, the original length of the wire is 744 cm. Mathematics question number 20. A rope P is 9.5 meter long. The length of rope Q is 2 by 5 of the length of rope P. What is the length of both the ropes? In order to find the length of rope Q, they have said that it is 2 by 5 of the length of P. So P is equal to 950 cm. So in order to find the rope Q, 2 by 5 into 950 cm is equal to 380 cm. So length of both the ropes is equal to 13.3 meter. Mathematics question number 21. Which of the following options shows the correct prime factorization of 72? In prime factorization, the end of the numbers should be a prime factor. Then only this prime factorization would be correct. Here, it is wrong because 1 is neither prime nor composite and 9 is not a prime number. In the C option, 4 is also not a prime number. So it is wrong. B is the correct option. Mathematics question number 22. A certain number when divided by 3 gives a remainder of 1. The same number when divided by 4 gives a remainder of 3. Which of the following can be the number? We're gonna go option wise. If we do this, we can see that 79 is the only number which satisfies this rule. Mathematics question number 23. If 7 by 25 of a number is 21 more than 1 by 4 of the same number, then find the number. Let the number be n. Given, 7 by 25 into n is equal to 1 by 4 into n plus 21. Now we'll bring all the n's to the same side. So 7n by 25 minus n by 4 is equal to 21. From this, we can get the value of n. So the value of n is equal to 700. Mathematics question number 24. Which of the following statements is or false? P. Successor of largest 7-digit number is 10 million. The largest 7-digit number is 99,99,999. Successor of the digit is 10 million. Yes, that is true. Q. Estimate value of largest 6-digit number rounded to the nearest hundredth is the smallest 6-digit number. The largest 6-digit number is 9,99,999. Rounding off to the nearest hundredth is 10 million, which is the smallest 7-digit number. So this statement is wrong because they have given smallest 6-digit number. Mathematics question number 25. Rajat bought 14 kgs for 460 grams of tomatoes. If he can put 1 kg 205 gram of tomatoes in each bag, then how many bags does he need to put all the tomatoes? Total of tomatoes Rajat bought is equal to 14 kg 460 gram. One bag contains 1 kg 205 gram. Number of bags needed to put 14 kg 460 gram of tomatoes is equal to total weight of tomatoes divided by how much kgs one bag can contain. So if we do that, we'll get 12 bags. Mathematics question number 26. Which of the following options is correct? In A, 1 liter is equal to 1000 ml. And the correct answer is 8042 ml. But they have given 842 ml. So this is wrong. In C, 1 km is equal to 1000 meter. So the correct answer is 75,015 meter. But they have given 7,515 meters. So it is wrong. In D, 1 milligram is equal to 100 decigrams. And 1 milligram is equal to 10 centigrams. So the correct answer is 250 milligrams. But they have given 205 milligrams to B option. 1 hectometer is equal to 100 meter. And 1 decameter is equal to 10 meter. And the correct answer is 340 meter. So B is correct. Mathematics question number 27. The given table shows the timing of a showroom. Study it carefully and answer the questions that follows. Samir arrived at the showroom at 8:15 a.m. on Wednesday. How long will he have to wait for the showroom to open? As we can see, Monday to Friday, the showroom opens at 9:30 a.m. So if we subtract that from the time he arrived, we will get 1 hour 15 minutes. The next question. If he arrived at the same time on Sunday, then how long will he have to wait? Saturday to Sunday, the showroom will open at 9:45 a.m. So similarly, if we subtract, we'll get 1 hour 30 minutes. So the answer is D. Mathematics question number 28. Which of the following figures shows 2 1 by 4 anti-clockwise rotation of the given figure? If we make two full turns, the figure will look the same. So the thing we have to concentrate here is 1 by 4. If it turns 1 by 4, then the answer would be A. Mathematics question number 29. The given table shows the fare of traveling from two cabs, X and Y. Study it carefully and answer the following questions. How much total money does she need to pay if she travels 4.5 km by cab Y and 3.5 km from cab X? Cab Y is equal to, for 1 hour, it's 24.50 rupees. For remaining 3.5 kilometers, that is 7.5 kilometers, 7 into 8.45, which is equal to 83.65. Let us find how many 1 by 2 is there in 3.5. Number of 1 by 2 in 3.5 is equal to 3.5 divided by 1 by 2, which is equal to 3.5 into 2 by 1, which is equal to 7. Similarly, we can apply this for cab X. For 1 hour, it is 28.40 rupees. And for remaining 2.5 kilometers, that is 5.5 kilometers, 5 into 6.25, which is equal to 59.65 rupees. In order to find the total money, we have to add cab Y and cab X, which is equal to 143.30 paise. Mathematics question number 30. Select the incorrect option. A triangle with all unequal sides is called a scalene triangle. Yes, that is correct. B. At 1:15, the smallest angle formed between two hands of the clock is an acute angle. That is also correct. C. Lines intersecting at 90 degree are called perpendicular lines. Yes, that is also correct. D. An angle greater than 90 degree but less than 360 degree is called an obtuse angle. No, this is wrong. An angle that is greater than 90 degree but less than 180 degree is called an obtuse angle. That's it for this video. Make sure to subscribe, hit that like button, turn on post notifications so that you guys never miss out on a video that I upload. And I'll see y'all next time. Goodbye.